Hello everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the first session of Java and Web installation and first program. In this video, we will differentiate between compilers and interpreters. Before we differentiate between compilers and interpreters, let's have a look on types of programming languages. There are two types of programming languages. First one is low-level language, also called machine language, and second one is high-level language. What is a low-level language? Low-level languages are close to hardware. The programming language which machine can understand is called machine language or low-level language. For example, low-level language or machine language is a series of binary bits, a series of zeros and ones. Human can hardly understand a machine language. What is high-level language? The programming language which human can understand is called high-level language, or in short HLL. They look like English and use various mathematical, logical and other type of operators. For example, C, C++, Java, Python, etc. are high-level languages. Human cannot understand the machine language and machine cannot understand the high-level language. As a human being, we need to write in high-level language. So we need something which converts high-level language to machine language. There are two types of software for this job. First one is compiler and second one is interpreter. Let's understand the working of the compiler. Here we have a high-level language code consists of 6 lines. We have a compiler who compiles this code. We pass this high-level language code to the compiler. Compiler works on it and create an intermediate compiled code. We have hard disk drive in our computer. We need to save the intermediate compiled code to the hard disk drive. And we save it to the hard disk drive. Further, we can send this intermediate compiled code to operating system for execution. This is job of operating system to schedule these machine instructions to the CPU for execution. We can later use this compiled code from hard disk again to run it without need for any compiler. Let's understand working of an interpreter. We have high level language code and we pass it to the interpreter. Interpreter does not work on all lines of high-level language together. It works on line by line of high-level language. This time, line 1 gets passed to the interpreter. After consuming line 1, the interpreter generates one or more machine instructions and pass it directly to the operating system without saving it on the hard disk. So this time, we are not saving the machine instruction on the hard disk. So this time we are not saving it as a compiled code. And in real time, OS need to execute them. And in real time, the OS need to schedule these machine instructions to the CPU. Compiler takes entire program as input and creates all executable instructions together as compiled code. But interpreter takes single instruction as input and creates one or more corresponding machine instructions. But compiler and interpreter are just responsible for creating machine instructions. They are not responsible for their execution. The operating system is responsible to schedule these instructions to the CPU. Compiler initially takes time because it has to create whole high-level language into machine language at once and save it on the hard disk drive as a compiled code. The file got saved is called compiled code or object code. The compiled code can be used again and again by the OS for execution. Once the compiled code is created, the operating system do not need the compiler once again. Once compilation is done, it's easy for the operating system to schedule the executable instructions to the CPU. Overall delay by compiler is less than interpreter. Because once the object file is created, OS does not need to wait for compiler to run a program again. If error occurs, the compiler does not create any single machine instruction. The object file, the compiled code file, will not be created at all. On the other hand, an interpreter does not create a file on the disk. Overall delay by interpreter is more than a compiler because there is no any saved file on the disk. The operating system always needs to wait for interpreter for execution of the code. If error occurs, then interpreter creates machine instruction for all the lines before the error. For example, if 7 high-level language instructions need to execute and there is an error at line number 3, then interpreter will execute the line from 1 to 2 and then stops. But in the same case, compiler will not create compiled object code at all. Here are some examples of programming languages use compiler, interpreter or both. C and C++ use only compiler, whereas Python and Perl use only interpreter. But Java uses both compiler and interpreter. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.